Betta fishes are beautiful and pet keepers love to have betta. But many of them struggle on feeding bettas because of their greedy appetites, which is confusing. Some bettas never hesitate when they see food, even if it means stealing from fellow tank mates. And some don't even take any food for weeks. Also, there's a lot of betta food types and options available in market. How do you know which foods are best for betta fish? How often should you feed them? Will they really eat until they're full, or are there feeding guidelines? Here we come up with a quick guide on betta fish foods. As lots of different types of betta fish food available, we like to bring to top 5 types most common and healthy betta foods in this video. At the end, you will find out some awesome bonus detail, so do watch the video till the end. Before we begin, we publish new betta videos every week, so be sure to subscribe for more awesome content. Let's get started. Number 5. Flakes. Flakes are the most popular betta fish food. They offer just enough nutrients that requires for bettas and found in almost any pet store. But their popularity is largely due to their cheap prices. They were designed to include all the main nutrition that your fish need, but they are less nutritious than freshly prepared or live foods. If you do plan on feeding your betta flakes, make sure you buy flakes specifically for bettas. Flakes for tropical fish will often contain vegetable and plant fillers, which are fine for omnivores, but won't provide your betta all the nutrients he's going to need. Tetramin Tropical Flakes, Omega-1 Betta Buffet Flakes, and Tetra Pro Betta Crisps are common betta flakes available in market to buy. Number 4. Pellets. Pellets are the most effective choice for bettas, an easy option for daily source of food. Unlike flakes, they are higher in nutrition quality. Pellets are perfect for betta fishes as they float in water. Since bettas prefer eating food on the surface, this floating pellet is more appetizing. It also allows you to closely monitor how much your fish has eaten, which helps prevent overfeeding. When choosing pellets, make sure that you're picking something that has at least 30% crude protein. Ideally, the ingredients should contain lots of dried meat and very little fillers, anything that isn't meat. Betta Bio Gold Pellets, Aquion Pro Betta Formula, Ocean Nutrition Betta Pellets, and Omega-1 Betta Buffet Pellets are common betta flakes available in pet stores. Number 3. Freeze-dried food. Freeze-dried foods are the same foods as live foods, only it's dried and all the moisture has been removed from the product. Freeze-drying is a method of preserving food in a lightweight, dry form factor while retaining as much of the original nutrients and taste as possible. Therefore, betta keepers love using freeze-dried bloodworms and brine shrimp as an alternative to live foods. Freeze-dried food gives huge protein boost and great tasting in little package. They have more nutrition in them than flakes and pellets because they're just freeze-dried animals. You can use freeze-dried food as a staple part of your betta's diet in combination with pellets to make sure your betta is getting all the nutrients he needs. Hikari Freeze-Dried Bloodworms, Tetra Bloodworms Freeze-Dried Treat, and Omega-1 bloodworms are excellent choices of freeze-dried food. Number 2. Frozen bloodworms. Frozen food is a great choice since it's nothing but same as live food that contains all the nutrients that betta get from live food, but isn't as expensive. Given that betta fish eat small insects, crustaceans, and other meaty foods in the wild, frozen bloodworms are one of the best foods you can give them. Sold at most local pet stores, they typically come in a package of foil-sealed individual cubes or a frozen slab that you can break off pieces from. Typically, one betta fish cannot finish an entire cube in one sitting, so you may need to thaw out the cube in a container and feed a few bloodworms using a pipette or tweezers. When you're giving your betta frozen food, make sure you defrost it in a small cup of his tank water. If you drop it in frozen, it will be too hard for him to eat and may do some damage. At least I knew, bettas do not like popsicle, haha! Betta Omega-1 Frozen Bloodworm and San Francisco Bay Frozen Brine Shrimp are some known frozen food options available in pet stores. If you like this video so far, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. This will help us to bring you awesome content like this more often. Now, let's get into the next betta food. Number 1. Live food. Live food is the most nutritional for your betta, as it's what he would eat in his natural habitat. It mainly consists of insects and small invertebrate. We recommend live blackworms as first choice, because as a true freshwater species, they can live for quite a while in your aquarium without fouling the water. also mostly available to buy it from local pet stores. Live food is going to bring out your beta's most natural behavior. He'll actually be hunting live animals, similar to what he'd do in the wild, which provides hours of enrichment for your beta fish as he hunts them down one by one. On personal experience, I do enjoy to see my betas running around the tank and hunting black worms, which is fun to watch. Main disadvantage of live food is price, availability, and maintenance. They're expensive, not always available at local fish stores, and do have the possibility of bringing in parasites. However, we still highly recommend them, given how nutritious and mentally stimulating they are for betas. Live foods can be found in Petco, PetSmarts, and your local pet stores. Usually, they bring them on specific days of the week. Just talk to your nearby pet store to know their live food availabilities days of week. Here I have few awesome bonus points, which I can't skip, while talking about beta food. Now you know the types, and you might have already picked some of the beta foods options for your pet. I like to cover a few more things that you can't skip. How often should you feed a beta fish? How to avoid overfeeding beta? What to feed beta fish when out of food? How to feed a beta fish while on vacation? Betas should eat once or twice a day. Adult betas can usually get by with one meal, while babies or young fish who are still growing will need two meals a day. Each time, you can feed 3 to 10 pieces of food based on your beta size. Overfeeding can lead to sickness, discomfort for the fish, and an unpleasant appearance. It's the main cause of problems with the digestive system and significantly impacts an ability of your fish to swim normally. So it's critical to feed limited quantity that your beta can take and clean up the food particles that are left in the tank after feeding time. There are actually quite a few things you can feed a beta in a pinch, and you might already have some of them in your kitchen. A beta will eat small pieces of tuna or shrimp, but make sure they're very small and remove anything left uneaten. Betas eat insects in the wild, so any kind of insect larva makes a nice treat for them too. There are a few things you can do if you're going on vacation and need to feed your beta. First, consider how long you'll be gone. If you're only going for a few nights or a long weekend, your beta will be okay until you get back. Any longer than that, though, and you'll have to take action. There are a few automatic feeders available in the market, but you must test them for a few times to make sure it works before setting them up during your vacation. Food blocks are another good option if you're going to be away for less than a week, but don't want to leave you fish without any food. Food blocks are designed to float on the water and slowly dissolve to release small amounts of food at a time. In our experience, most betas are not too picky, and if kept in a community tank with other fish, may even choose to snack on other foods you feed the aquarium. But if you're looking to add more variety to your beta's meal plan, give one of these top 5 go-to foods. I'm sure your beta fish is sure to beg for more, and thank me as well. Haha! Thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe for more awesome beta videos.